In this video, we'll talk about role center on the X4. And how is role center different on the X4 compared to the T4 and other touring cars? Since we have a new suspension with the new type of arms, the role center is adjusted in a different way. So as you may remember, on the T4, we had suspension inserts, which we used to alter the role center, which we changed the hinge pin height of the arms. On these arms, we changed the height of the arms using shims. So as you can see here, we have shims installed between arms and the chassis to change the height of the arms. And these shims that are included are 2 millimeters thick. That's the basic roll center setting. If you go higher with the shimming, obviously you'll raise the lower roll center. And if you remove shims, you'll lower the roll center. So the kit setting of 2 millimeters of shimming is a good basic setting, especially for carpet. We tend to use a bit higher lower arms for asphalt racing to free up the car and to get more corner speed. But on carpet, in general, we've been using lower shimming. So what happens when you raise the roll center? You'll remove side bite, the car will be freer in the corner and will have more corner speed. But it will also react faster, so a higher roll center will give you more initial reaction and more initial steering for that reason. But we also often play with the relation between the front and rear arm height. So we often use a rear arm, which is 0.5 or even 1 millimeter higher than the front arm, to have a higher rear roll center compared to the front. And this often gives us a good balance for different tracks, different conditions, especially for higher grip conditions, to make the rear have less chassis roll than the front. And this gives you a really good corner speed, but still with a very precise feeling of the car. So this is mainly recommended for asphalt racing. On carpet, we've had good luck with the same arm height, front and rear, for most conditions. Let's see how we can adjust the roll center using the upper arms on the X4. As you know, we have completely new upper arms on the X4, and we're able to adjust the roll center with shims for the upper arms, just like for the lower arms. So we have 3 points here where we can adjust the shimming. We have the outer point and the 2 inner points. The kit setting is to have 2 millimeters of shims on the outside rear upper arm point and 0.5 millimeters on the inside point. If we want to reduce the rear grip, if we want to free up the rear, we'll have to go higher with the rear upper arm inside point. So we have to add shims to the inside to raise these 2 points up. Or we can go lower on the outside point. This will give you less camber gain. It will lower the roll center, but it will give you less camber gain, which will give you less side bite in the corner. So this will free up the rear. If you're looking for more rear grip, you'll have to lower the inside shimming or raise the outside shimming, or both. This will give you a higher roll center, but with more camber gain. This will give the rear more grip, especially coming out of the corner on power. And this is a very sensitive setting, of course, which you can change in very small steps by the use of shims for the upper arms. The exact same theory applies to the front of the car. We can once again adjust the roll center with shims under the upper arms. The kit comes with a 2 millimeter shim to use on the outside point and 1.5 millimeters of shims to use on the inside point. But then again, this can be changed, of course, depending on the balance of the car. If you need more front grip, more steering, you need to lower the inside point or raise the outside point or both. And if you want to go the other way, if you're struggling with traction rolling or that the car is too difficult to drive, too direct, you'll have to raise the inside point and lower the outside point with shims. This will take away some camber gain in the corner, it will reduce the front side bite, and it will lower the roll center. Those are the options we have to change the upper arm roll center. The other new option which we have on the X4 to change the car's roll center and the axle height is to change the height of the hubs. As you may have noticed during the build is that we now have the option to add and remove shims between the hub and the lower arm. When you raise the axle height, we'll take away grip from that end of the car. This will free up the car and will give you more corner speed. Same thing goes when you lower the shimming, you'll get more traction on that end of the car and it will give you more grip. So you cannot go any lower than a 0.5 millimeter shim, because if you go any lower, the screw which holds this aluminium piece here will touch the arm. So you cannot go lower than 0.5, but you can go as high as you want. Basically, you can go up to 1, 1.5, even 2 millimeters of shims under the hubs front and rear. We've had good success with raising the rear axle height on both carpet and asphalt, and especially in spec classes. And I really recommend playing with axle height if you feel comfortable with making those changes to the car. And we have this option both in front and rear, and it's really a big difference on the track and a really useful tuning option. But you need to keep in mind that when you change the axle height, you'll have to make a compensation for that with your droop setting, with your downstop setting. So let's say that you go 0.5 millimeters higher with your rear hub, you're gonna take some droop out of the car. So when you're doing that, for example, you're adding 0.5 millimeters of shims under the rear hub to raise it up. Then you're gonna have to remove 0.5 from your downstop setting. So for example, if you were at 4.6 or 4.8 rear downstop, you're gonna have to take 0.5 away from that. So you're gonna have to go for a setting around 4.2 to have the same amount of droop as you had before you changed the axle height. And of course, it's the other way around. When you lower the rear axle height, you'll get more droop, so you have to use a higher downstop number in that case. And I hope that information was useful for you about changing the axle height and changing the roll center of your X4.